didn't happen, it decreased the quality of the work they were doing. Anita alluded to it before, it happened in my ward on Airby Road. They came and resurfaced it, and within weeks, it diminished. So I hope, I do hope it works, and I very much welcome coming back in-house. But yes, I think the contract with BAM has been an absolute utter disaster. And on that note, I'll finish. Thank you. Thank you, Mark. And I'd now like to bring over to the hot seat, Alan Evans. Oh, a recommendation. I do apologise. A recommendation for the report to be noted. Please. Thank you, Dave. Thank you, Steve. The outcomes of the China visit.
Chair, with your permission, I'm Sally Shah, the
Sally, I do apologise.
General Store. Shall I introduce myself?
Please.
I'm Sally Shah, I'm the Lead Commissioner for Place and Investment within the Economic and Housing Growth Directorate. And with your agreement, I'd just like to do a very brief sort of bit of background to the report and then take you just through to some of the key elements of it. As I'm sure you know, attracting inward investment and sort of increasing business growth are two of the pledges that we have within our rural growth plan. And we carry out a range of activities to support this. That includes working with partners such as the Royal Chamber, such as our City Region partners, to attract inward investment from overseas markets. Working with partners, we've been able to extend the reach that we have as a council. If we just tried to do it by ourselves, we wouldn't be able to reach the markets that we, or the leads that we are able to reach as we can do with working with our city region partners. And as a, working as a combined authority, we've been able to attract some funding through European funding to deliver a place marketing programme. And as part of that, that's enabled us to target particular sectors and markets which provide the most opportunities for growth and therefore inward investment into the borough. China has been identified as one of those markets, and by carrying out that type of activity, we've been able to set out in the report, we've been able to support and provide opportunities for rural companies to establish trading and export relationships. Back in 2016, which is obviously this report is talking about a visit that took place in 2016, we had feedback from a number of businesses that there was strong interest in visiting China because they wanted to look at how they could explore trade opportunities in China. And other businesses, whilst not necessarily wanting to visit, wanted to have further information and the opportunity to potentially develop that as a market. And so that a trip was planned, it was a city region trip, and obviously it says in the report that Davis was there because of his portfolio, his city region portfolio responsibilities. And it built on the relationships that we already had developed in southwest China and Tianjin, because that reflected the particular areas of sector strengths that we had as a city region and also in Wirral, particularly around areas such as engineering and manufacturing and marine technology. The report sets out these details of the trip and the outcomes for Wirral, which includes, I think we've sort of talked in the report about there being a business opportunity, an immediate business opportunity for one of the rural businesses that went on the trip, plus Tranmere Rovers have been able to extend the work they're doing with in Mongolia. And the Chamber has also been able to provide feedback to the businesses that didn't attend, and also businesses that have come through since that time, about being more informed about how they can support rural businesses to export and take on board the potential export opportunities. I think the key feature of the trip was, in terms of the objectives which were set out in the report, was about establishing those local government links with the range of Chinese cities that were visited and identified in the report. Because, as you're probably aware, it's a prerequisite, really, for Chinese companies that want to do business with or overseas companies, that they need to have that government link in order to be able to do so. So that was one of the key objectives of the trip, was to establish that. But of course, it wasn't just about the government officers and members attending, going on the trip. It's very much about the businesses going as well, because that's one of the key aims, is to enable businesses to develop those links. And as I say, that's really something that we've been able to build on since that trip, with the culmination most recently has been the International Business Festival, where we've seen over 200 overseas delegations coming to the Business Festival, but 25 of those delegations were Chinese delegations, and they've picked up on a number of the opportunities that really start in life with some of these visits that was done back in 2016. I'd also just point out that there's a wider sort of social and educational element to the visits as well, because whilst it was a business trip, it's those sorts of relationships that have enabled other relationships to flourish. For instance, back in since 2015, Wirral Chamber signed a memorandum of understanding with the Taichung General Chamber of Commerce, and resulting from that, we now have 11 schools within Wirral who are partnering with schools in China. There's a number that have been bilateral sort of annual trips. I think to now, since that time, we've had over 500 inbound Chinese students coming, and over 200 Wirral students have gone back to China as well. So that's establishing links both on the sort of educational and social side, but also cultural side as well, which could well lead to business opportunities, obviously, in the future. And just to finish, one of the, as it's sort of set out in the report, about the Chengdu exhibition centre, where there is the opportunity there, and it was very developed on that trip, for local rural businesses to exhibit sort of free of charge and to showcase their wares in China. And that's something, again, that we've been able to pick up when Councillor Davis met with the delegation from Qingdao that came over at the International Festival for Business. So we'll be able to support companies in developing further links through that.
Thank you. Thanks, Sally. Is there anything you'd like to add to that? Are any members present?
Just a question, really. And I don't wish to sound negative, obviously, but probably will come across as negative. I mean, I'm concerned that the financial implications aren't scrapped out. We're all told, obviously, where the costs are coming from, and it would be nice to just see the actual sum that was spent on the cost of this. And we would probably await that, but if you can drop it in a note on that separately, that would be useful. I think what the public, and obviously, we're as elected members speak on behalf of the public, they know the council leader went out to China, and they know he was accompanied by people from the Liverpool City region and beyond, and the global businesses. But they want to know what has he brought back, what is going to happen, what businesses are going to invest, in Birkenhead, in Swansea, and the rest of the world. So while this is all very good, I understand as much as the next person how important it is to build those links with people in other countries. I mean, but many of us, some of us around this table, we were involved when we were first given Objective 1 status, and clearly, we built those relationships up, and dare I say, we met the delightful Michel Barnier at that time, who was actually in charge of our region for that. But clearly, we understand how important it is, but I think as far as residency, and they might be, slightly tunnel vision on us, they want to see spades going in the ground, the jobs coming, and I know that takes time. Is there anything of that we could point to? I mean, I'm not asking you to commit to anything, specific, but is there going to come a time when we're actually seeing these spades going in the ground, people getting jobs out of this, and what will we expect in the future?
Yes, we can point to, there's two businesses, which is really, I can't name the specific business. In terms of the investment opportunity, there is a business that has already done, is working with a Chinese company on the export. It's not investment in that particular case, it's enabling a company from where on to export to China. And on the back of that, that is obviously supports the growth of that business. Particularly, we do have examples as well of investment coming into Europe, and that's in connection with the student accommodation that's taking place in Birkenhead at the moment. There's investment from China that's involved in that particular undertaking. So those are just two examples of some of the direct response, I suppose, to those areas.
And a note on the costs.
Yes, yes, I have.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Chair.
Thanks,
Dave.
Thank you, Chair. Well presented, sorry, thank you very much. Again, it's the same line as yourself, because as I was reading through the report, I was making the comments at the end of reading this particular one. 3.3 pledges from World Road, land, etc. What benefits, if any, have we seen? But these are the points. Have we seen anything from this? Have we seen any benefits? Then again, the approach to work with partners, that's in 3.4. Have we seen any returns from that? We know it's a long, slow process, but as you said in your opening speech, it's get past the bubble first, the Chinese bubble first, and moving forward. I did try my best when I was the mayor by inviting the consul general to the world. He's changed since, but yeah, I did try. And again, research undertaken by the department to investigate trade. How long will it take? These are all things. It's good to see what we actually need to see. Things on the ground here, jobs being created, firms being, doing lots of work. Yes, delegation by journalists, as you said, with our leader. Have we seen any more follow-ups on this? As you said, one company at the time, and there's been a few more since. Are we actually seeing it moving forward now? Even though, 2 years on, we need to be able to do something from it.
I think it's a step, sort of there's some practical examples of what has happened in those 2 years, which is sort of outlined in the report, and I've sort of outlined just now. I think it's also the fact that we're not suggesting in terms of the trips that we're carried out at that point, it was very much about laying the foundations with the businesses themselves to take up those opportunities and to work with Chinese businesses. And that, I think, is a very important part of it, because if we hadn't laid the groundwork, we wouldn't be seeing any further work, because, as I said, it is about that the Chinese understanding that we as a local government have a commitment to, and will be supporting trade and business with China through our businesses. And there's been, I suppose, in terms of practical outcome, again, it is the fact that those companies have come back with missions from the delegations from through the International Festival for Business. So we've seen those 25 delegations which brought businesses with them. And again, further discussions, I know there was matchmaking as part of that festival, where individual businesses meet with other individual businesses, and certainly in terms of rural businesses, they were very much represented at the festival. So these things, unfortunately, don't happen overnight. It is very much about enabling businesses to move forward, and I suppose I would also say it is one part of what we're doing in terms of attracting inward investment. It's an important part, but there are other activities that we do with our city region partners as well, and certainly the follow-up to that trip is very much now not needing the politicians or officers to follow up on that. It is businesses who are now able to follow up on the opportunity.
Thanks. Can I just say, just before I bring you in, Anita, we are going to follow up on the work programme for this year from the committee. Thanks, Sally. Anita.
Thanks, Chair. Hopefully with the imminent settlement of Brexit, we need to sort of like explore further fields, and I welcome the work that the council is doing outside of Europe, and as you said, we do need to sow seeds. I have had some involvement with Travelling Rovers as their training ground sits within my ward. I've heard many tales told about how you can be discussing things a year ago, and then all of a sudden you'll get a phone call saying, okay, we want to do that next week or next month. So, you know, it's sort of, when you talk about culture, I think that's something that the council really needs to accept and respect, is that the culture is, I want it and I want it now. And I think we have to be able to be responsive to that request. You know, I've had a conversation with Mark Pallios from Tramier Rovers, and he said, we've got 45 people coming to Wirral next week. Is there anywhere where we can put them up? You know, and it's a simple. And also, you know, sort of the investment through the embedded head with the development there for the students, you know, that's absolutely welcomed. I went to have a look at the showrooms, really, that they had put together, and they're absolutely fabulous. And I've got some pictures on the phone, I would like to see them. But in terms of quality, what we're seeing is quality work being brought to Wirral.
Thank you, Jean.
Thank you.
Thanks very much, Ali, for that. I really, really appreciated it. We all know that it's absolutely vital to attract more businesses to Wirral. So I think the work you're doing, the old team and Alan's team, is vital, because what we've got to do is say to businesses, council is behind you, the regional authority is behind you, and it's a partnership. And we're all working together to make sure we do everything to bring new businesses here, create more jobs for our own people. So really, really appreciate the work you're doing. And I always want to end on a positive note. I was going to mention the student accommodation. Anita and I went to George to see it, and I think I'd spoken to Eric Robinson about it earlier, and he was trying to describe it, and I think, and what it could bring to Howard Square area and everything. And I was going, yeah, okay, yeah. But I understood when I saw this, and you could just see the vision then. So that, you'd need, once students are there, you need outlets for them for food, restaurants, entertainment and stuff. So there's massive opportunities to develop that area just with that one facility. And it was absolute quality. So I've been showing it to everybody, the photos I took on my thing. And I, you know, I've got a special interest in it because I was born just over the road from there. So it's heartbreaking for me to see how the area has deteriorated. And to think that it's got a future now is really heartwarming. So thanks for everything you did.
Thanks, Jim.
Thank you, Chair. Hi, Sally. Hi, Alan. Nice to see you. Just a couple of things, if I may. I hope it's been negative. Just a couple of things, if I may. The recent TV programme, I'm sure a number of people around the table saw, about investment in the city region, and we're all in the city region, particularly over in Liverpool with the Chinatown debacle. Still is a debacle, the more you read about it as well, after that TV program. And nearer home, obviously, what happened with the investor, the Chinese investor, with the International Business Park. But more importantly, they said, that it's hitting the confidence of investors over there, particularly those investors linked to government circles to invest here in the city region. Have you found anything of the sort in dealing with those investors, particularly those who you met, or officers and politicians you met over in China? Be interested to hear. And in terms of investment, obviously, to be welcomed, the Tranmere side of this, I know. And good to hear over the student accommodation. But is there anything concrete, forgive the pun, anything concrete in terms of developments in the pipeline, any investment, big style? We hear that the big, huge ambitions we have, and rightly so, we all want to see that come into the fore. But I don't hear of anything in terms of investments happening. And maybe it's because of that commercial confidentiality, I understand that. And lastly, in terms of the nuts and bolts behind that to make that happen, yeah, which is important, is it not, in terms of the officer corps and the politicians, yeah, with that visionary zeal, go up a gear and more to actually deliver on it, on what we're promising, on what we're saying, on what we want to do. I don't understand, I have to say, I haven't read some documents, and maybe I'm wrong, in terms of the officers set up, and the new officer set up, I believe, that's either out now or coming out, in terms of how we're going to deliver this, and how, lastly, all that marries together, stitches together, things like the World Growth Club, things like World Waters, and other big ticket projects, and in terms of how we bring all that together, because it is a huge, huge agenda, is it not? And I know there's a lot of questions here, forgive me, Sally, but I cannot get my head around all of it, really can't. Sorry to be negative.
Just to clarify, Sally, I think Pat was alluding to the Chinatown debacle where it led to nothing, yes, and the inference that the Chinese are looking at what's going on in Liverpool and it's putting them off investing in anywhere in Liverpool, because it is called Liverpool City Region, and it was when the Liverpool City Region was named, it was named thus because Liverpool's a big internationally known city, but the stuff going on over there that could turn developers, investors off. And again, what Pat said there about the growth company, Peel, Will Waters, international investment. So it's all that, which is hopefully it's all interlinked. If you'd like to comment on that, Sally.
In respect of the confidence of Chinese investors, what I'd say to that is that there's the evidence from the interest that was shown at the International Business Festival of these Chinese delegations coming across and wanting to look at the opportunities in the Liverpool City region. That's not been diminished, that's actually increased, because if you look at the number of delegations that came 2 years ago, which I think we were in the region of about 8 or 9, was 25 from China this year. So I think the evidence that they wanted to come to the Liverpool City region is strong. There's also one of the examples I didn't give details of previously was that there's a world company that's looking to set up an investment fund around innovation, looking for Chinese investment to support with innovation. As a result, that person, that business, has been over to China at least half a dozen times and is successfully securing investment. Now, to my mind, that is the evidence appears to be that it hasn't damaged what's happened to Liverpool, hasn't damaged the reputation of the city region. I think as well that obviously, just in terms of China, there's obviously this concern, you know, a couple of years ago, there was some concern actually about the Chinese economy itself and how stable it was. And I think if you, again, looking at the sort of the government announcements from the Department of Industry and Trade around that, that seems to have stabilised. So there certainly was an element of just from China's own kind of retrenching around how they were looking at investment. But that, again, DIT are now saying that they're now looking for that stabilised and they are looking to continue the investment. And as I say, that's the evidence that we've had sort of anecdotally and practically in terms of the festival is certainly true. In terms of the other questions, do you want me to, in terms of responding to that, I suppose, in terms of what you're saying about the structure, yes, obviously we're now in the Directorate for Economic and Housing Growth. What I could say is that as an officer, I'm working with zeal, and as you say, so wanting to make things happen. I feel that that is very, the structure will support us to be able to do that. That I feel that when I first, you know, a few years ago, when we first started, and perhaps the issue of the, as you refer to the International Trade Center, which was Chinese, but that didn't take place, there was a lot of talk about ideas, or lots of sort of concepts. It was very much at that stage. I think I am personally incredibly excited about the fact that we've got to the point now where there are some actual projects, whether it's within Wirral Waters or whether it's with the Wirral Growth Company. We've got past that concept stage. There are projects that are going to come forward, and I think the structure that we've got now will enable that to come forward at pace, which is part of the, obviously, the reason for the working in partnership with the part of the Wirral Growth Company. So I think that's probably my response to that.
Thanks, Sean. David, I'd just like to come on.
Just very quickly on the structure. Clearly, the council has appointed a new director of housing and growth, Brian Bailey, started this week. He comes with a very extensive track record of experience in that area. And the restructure that's just been carried out holds all the functions together, as Sally alluded to, under that area, and the separations we've made between the strategic elements of those pieces of work, housing and economic growth, and the delivery, which I'm looking at in the day-to-day life of the council. So that separation's been made absolute. Senior persons come in, teams have been reorganised around that directorate. Clearly we'll still work together, so for example the assets has been split, Jeanette's taken the strategic function into the housing and economic growth area, back on the day-to-day function, clearly we'll still talk to each other. It actually means the council is much more focused and has all the people together to actually tackle the housing and the economic development agenda in a different way. I think it's a good move personally.
Thanks, Nick. Thanks, Sally. And I'd just like to say that we put this on the agenda, and I'd like to thank the two party spokespersons here, Steve and Dave. We talked about the visits that have gone on, not just China and my dad. And I think it's been worthwhile tonight you coming along, and I feel much better about it. But I can assure the committee that we are going to come back to this, which I'll come on to later on the agenda, on our web programme to bring all of this together. But that's been a positive start for us, so thank you.
Thank you.
Now, can I ask the